Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Connor. I'm here with my father,
Kevin.
I cannot describe how excited I am to do this album. It's been a highly requested album on the channel since we started it, especially since we dived into hip-hop a little bit. For those of you who aren't familiar, we did his first hip-hop record a couple weeks back, To Pimp a Butterfly by Kendrick Lamar. You enjoyed that record?
I did. It was an introduction to hip-hop that I didn't see coming.
Yeah, so we're back here with another critically acclaimed hip-hop record that you have not listened to. And this is one of my favorite records of all time. Before we get started, I just want to ask you a few questions.
Mm-hmm.
So you're not familiar with any Kanye West music?
I know that one goofy thing he came out with. It was Doop Doo Loop or something like that.
The Swoop?
Swoop.
Poop Dee Swoop?
Poop Dee Swoop.
Yeah.
It's the only thing
Lift
I know.
Yourself was the title of the track.
Mm-hmm.
So you really only know Kanye for, I guess, what you see in the news and pop culture.
Yeah, I remember when his mom had passed. I remember the MTV Awards. I remember the TV shows, and then I know that he moved to a farm. That's probably the extent.
The most recent, he moved to a farm, right?
Yeah, and I just read 2 hours ago he sent a court document to change his name to Ye.
To Ye.
Ye, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, so that's super recent. Basically, I wanted to ask that just because, yeah, you have no idea of what he does musically or why he's such a significant person in the hip-hop culture.
Zero. No, zero. I really honestly zero, nothing.
Which is, I find it so interesting because, you know, to me, I see all this crazy stuff that Kanye will do and the whole the Trump thing and the Taylor Swift incident and all everything that he's done.
Yeah.
But I have listened to every single one of his albums, so I'm like, to me, it's like I try to ignore that as much as I can and just really appreciate what he does artistically.
Mm-hmm.
But for you, it's probably just you just see that and it's like, what the hell is this guy doing? Why are people
praising
this guy?
Yeah, I saw that him in Trump, and I saw him with MTV and doing, you know, just some strange shit. But then I heard that he had some issues, and then I understood a little bit more that he did have some issues that could have been contributing to this, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So It's gonna be an interesting listen for me. I don't know what he does lyrically, and I really don't know what he does musically. I just, you know, I know that he was a producer before, which he told me.
Yeah. I gave him a quick crash course yesterday. He's not going into this album completely raw. I didn't give him any music, like I didn't show him any music, but I did show him a video. I think it was titled like The Making of My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, and I showed him the first 5 minutes of it, so I'll put it in the link in the description. It's a good watch. It's like half an hour long, but I showed him just enough to get an idea, and you kind of got an idea now.
You know what, exactly, in that little short clip I got an idea and a good understanding of what happened and
where he was when he was making this album.
Yeah,
mentally, physically as well, out in Hawaii and mm-hmm. and all that. So yeah, I'm excited to get into this. So, sunglasses are off. As you've already noticed, we've got the suits on today. I felt like it was fitting for this album. And I could not find a tie for the life of me. You were looking around the house too, right?
I looked everywhere. I couldn't find the second tie.
So, yeah, I feel a little bit left out today because I know you've got the tie and then you've also got the dress shoes if you want to show them to the camera. So he went a little more into it than me. I've got the black Converse on with no tie. So anyways.
And we both have no underwear. So that's one thing we have in unison.
That's true. So track number one is titled Dark Fantasy. It's featuring Nicki Minaj, Teyana Taylor, and Bon Iver.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, yeah, let's get into it.
Sick addiction will gather around children's epic lesson.
Oh, I like that.
Can we get much higher?
So high.
Wow. But the production is...
Can we get much higher?
Crazy layering, eh? Wow.
Fantasize about this back in Chicago. Mercy, mercy me, that mercy will I go. That's me, the first year that I blow. How you say broke in Spanish, me no I blow. And fire up the engines, huh? And then they make noise.
Can we get much higher?
So high.
This part is epic, eh? Wow.
Yeah, like grand.
It's huge.
At the mall, there was a seance. Just kids, no parents. Then the sky filled with herons.
We saw the devil and the Chrysler LeBaron.
And the hell it would spare us. And the fires they declare us. But after that, took pills, kissed and arrows. And woke up back in Paris.
Can we get much higher?
So high.
This is such a different part.
I love the song, yeah.
Yeah, the beat just drops right out and it's just... Wicked.
So that's the intro track, Dark Fantasy.
Fuck, that was pretty cool. Pretty cool.
from a production standpoint.
It's amazing. The production was absolutely amazing. And that drop out, where they drop the beat and then you come in with that so much higher. Who's singing the main line? Is that... Do we know who that...
I believe it's Tiana Taylor.
Wow.
At least she's listed on the track.
Yeah, that her voice is absolutely incredible.
And then Bon Iver is also on here. And then Nicki Minaj does the intro little speech.
Yep.
I don't know if she does other vocals on the track, but... Yeah, that's the intro to it. Were you able to make out any of his themes or lyrics?
Yeah, I was. You know what? I totally was. And I was just thinking of it here. It's just when he's talking about the plan was to drink until the pain's all over, but what's worse, the pain or the hangover, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure if this was dealing with that whole... being the opening track, if it was dealing with the whole thing with his mom and all that stuff that had happened, right?
Mm-hmm.
But easy lyrics to follow, right? You can just, it's straight out.
Well, yeah, in contrast to the Kendrick Lamar album, I feel like this has a lot of kind of tongue-in-cheek lyrics. And just kind of, you'll notice as we progress through the album.
Well, that's it. Right away, too many Urkels on your team. That's why your win's low, right?
Yeah. Just before we get into track number two, did you ever watch the South Park episode where they made fun of Kanye? Something about fish sticks?
No.
Okay.
I don't even know what that is.
Well, I'll just tell you, they did an episode. I don't even remember what it was. It was making fun of his singing or something, and something to do with a fish stick and fish dicks or something. Anyway, you just need to know that, because when the line comes up, you'll have a lot of questions if I didn't tell you that now.
Okay.
Moving on to track number two. It's titled Gorgeous. It's featuring my man, Kid Cudi, and Raekwon.
Ain't no question if I want it, I need it. I can feel it slowly dripping away from me. I'm on the edge, so why you playing? I'm saying I will never, ever let you live this down.
So this is
Kid
Cudi.
Nothing, okay, I dream it. I can feel it slowly drifting away from me.
OK.
Cuddy's got a great voice.
It's amazing voice.
Yeah.
Penitentiary chances, the devil dances and eventually answers to the call of autumn. All them falling for the love of balling. Get caught with 30 rocks, the cop look like Alec Baldwin. Inner century anthems, this is my Olympics. We make them say oh, cause the game's so pimpish. Choke a South Park writer with a fish stick. I insisted to get up off of this dick. And these drugs, niggas can't resist it. Remind me when they try to have Ali enlisted. If I ever wasn't the greatest nigga, I must have missed it.
I like this track.
Oh, yeah?
This hook is really good.
The Kid Cudi kills this hook.
I'm on the edge, so why you playing? I'm saying I will never ever.
He's sitting there fucking coach. My guy said I need a different approach. Cause people is looking at me like I'm sniffing coke. It's not funny anymore. Try different jokes. Tell them hug and kiss my ass. X and O. And kiss the ring while they at it. Do my thing while I got it. Play strings for the dramatic ending of that whack shit.
I don't cop Tim's. Is lived in lenses. Kid Armani suits. Fresh fruits. Valley boots and Benzes. Counting up smoking. One cuff. Live as a red jag. A Louis bag. Grabbing the blunt. Fuck it, steam about 101 L's. Kites off the jails, buying sweats, running up in Stetson. Nigga had game was special. It matched every black pair of Nikes, throwing dice for
down, down.
I like that guitar part too.
Yeah.
It's interesting because it's dirty enough, and Kanye's vocals were dirty.
Yeah,
yeah. So it's got this contrast going between the two. What an absolutely great hook. Like everything went well in this song. The hook mm-hmm. was just, the hook was amazing, man. Bringing That's... in these first two, the hooks, whoever, maybe it's Kanye, he's the producer, right?
Yeah, yeah.
To have these really, really catchy hooks in there, right?
Yeah. No, like, I wow. mean, Kid Cudi is like the hook god.
Is he?
Throughout Kanye albums and his own albums as well. But yeah, like to go...
That is going to be stuck in my head. Seriously, I'm humming it constantly. Yeah.
It's a really cool contrast of, because the hook is very... His vocals are open, mm-hmm. Kid Cudi's.
Yeah.
Then the guitar is very distorted and kind of like you. What was your word you were saying?
Oh, just distorted. Yeah.
Oh, distorted.
Just distorted. Yeah.
But then same with Kanye's vocals.
His were distorted. Yeah.
Yeah. So it kind of went back and forth between the verse and the hook.
I thought our headphones were clipping because when he came in, I thought they were clipping because you never hear that really used.
No, not often,
right?
Yeah. Moving along to track number three. It's titled Power. And there's no features. There's some production credits and vocal, backup vocals that I have listed here, but I'm mm-hmm. not going to go through everybody. So we'll just, no features for this one.
Okay.
So track number three, Power.
Man, I love how they put everything to this side, eh?
Yeah.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing to lose, motherfucker, we rolling. Motherfucker, we rolling.
Oh, this is really interesting, eh?
Yeah, quick change up.
Yeah.
Between that and the sample and the drum.
Was he the first one to do this sort of thing?
Sort of,
yeah.
Jumping out the window, letting everything go.
Power.
Wow, it's when you said there was no features, I didn't think there'd be a big hook, but he makes the hook himself.
Right? Yeah, well, there's a sample, the King Crimson 24th Century or 21st.
Oh,
21st, century,
yeah, yeah. But I mean, the No Man Should Have All That Power. The clock's ticking.
No,
that's
his hook.
It's
yeah.
his hook, right? So, yeah. And it's really, really cool, man. I was just gonna say, I'm pleasantly surprised because I didn't really. What we talked about earlier is that with the early, with the, all the shit on the news and stuff like that,
mm-hmm.
Kanye, I didn't know what to expect,
mm-hmm.
right? And there's definitely more than what I expected, and it's just fucking good. Like,
yeah,
it's good. Just good. I didn't, you know what I mean? I didn't give him much credit, not really knowing what he did, but just seeing him in the news and stuff like that. So as a producer, first off, he's fucking incredible.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the production is really, really cool, and I like that he changed, like, right to that distorted vocals, mm-hmm. and then to the third track coming in and not having somebody for this big hook, just coming in at it for himself.
Yeah,
just the power of just doing it by myself and not having that big, huge, you know, sweet hook, right, going.
Yeah. So track number 4 is an interlude that goes into track number 5. So we're gonna play them together.
Okay.
So track number 4 is All of the Lights interlude, and then track number 5 is All of the Lights.
Okay.
So here's the lyrics. All of the Lights is, I'll go through the features because it's a pretty big list of features. All of the Lights featuring Rihanna, Ellie Jackson, Kid Cudi, Fergie, Drake, Alicia Keys, Elton John, Alvin Fields, Kenneth Lewis, John Legend, Tony Williams, Ryan Leslie, The Dream, and Charlie Wilson.
This is on one track.
This is one track, yeah.
And do you want me to try to pick them all out and say?
You can give it your best shot.
Okay. I'm going to guess that's Alicia Keys playing piano right there. That sounds like her fingers. This is a beautiful piece of music. Oh, I love that cello. Makes me sad. All of the lights. Wow. Oh, this is pretty cool. That brass section.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I want to sit up straight with this. Rihanna. Elton John on the tuba.
Nigga replacing me, I had to take him to that ghetto university. All of the lights, cop lights, flashlights, spotlights, strobe lights, street lights. All of the lights, all of the lights. Fast life, drug life, thug life, rock life, every night. All of the lights,
all of the lights in here, baby.
In mind, baby, gotta let this nigga live.
This is Kid Cudi.
Oh, this is
Kid.
Unemployment line, credit card decline. Did I not mention I was about to lose my mind?
Mine.
Was about to do that line. Can't be, you know we're going all the way this time. Going all the way this time. We're going all the way this time.
There's so much going on in this track, eh?
Yeah.
Things.
Drake was in there.
Was Drake there?
Yeah.
I thought I heard Elton John doing the piano part. Sound like his fingers.
Turn up the lights, young baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this. Turn up the lights, young baby.
Oh, there's Elton.
You know I don't need, want you to see.
And then Alicia Keys comes in after this.
Oh, there's Alicia. Hey, Alicia. See that piano playing right there? Sounds like Elton John.
Yeah.
Yeah. The beginning sound is like Alicia. That was a... That... Okay. Now, listen, young artists trying to make an album. Listen to that song and see how it's done.
Yeah. No, 100%.
Was okay, I don't know, but was this a big one off the...
I think this was the most popular song.
Was it?
Yeah.
There's a reason. That was absolutely something else. Wow.
From a production standpoint,
production,
you liked it?
Production, lyrics, everything about this track was good. That is how you do a track.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know what else to say now. Seriously, I'm not joking. No word. Seriously, just go to the next track.
Speechless.
No, it's that. Fuck, it's that good. Like,
yeah. Well, it was very unpredictable too. I know when I first listened to it, I was like, what is going on? When it, like, the beginning, it seems structured, which it is.
Yeah.
You know, because it's chorus first, chorus verse, and then the bridge comes in with Kid Cudi, and then Fergie comes in, and then Rihanna and Drake, and then Elton John and Alicia Keys, and it's just, everything is just
But you know what's nuts? When you read that initially, I thought
you didn't understand how it would work.
I didn't think it would work musically. I thought there's no way this can work. There's too many different styles and too many different things going on.
Mm-hmm.
It worked.
Mm-hmm.
It really worked. It really did. And because you didn't have people taking over things. They just had their little parts, which was
tiny little part that added so much to the song. Yeah.
Yeah. Elton's harmonies in there, right?
Mm-hmm.
Coming in, and he did really, really good. Fucking wow. I'm listening to that again tonight. I'm not joking. I will have that in my headphones. I have to digest that again.
Track number 6 is titled Monster. It's featuring Jay-Z, Rick Ross, Nicki Minaj, Bon Iver, and Charlie Wilson.
I shoot the lights out until it's bright out. Just another lonely night.
So this part is Rick Ross.
Are you willing to sacrifice your life?
Bitch, I'm a monster, no good blood sucker. Fat motherfucker, now look who's in trouble. As you run through my jungles, all you hear is rumbles. Kanye West samples, here's one for example.
Gossip, nigga, just stop it. Everybody know
I'm a motherfucking monster.
I'ma need to see your fucking hands at the concert. I'ma need to see your fucking hands at the concert. Profit, nigga, I got it. Everybody know I'm a motherfucking monster.
When my older bitch acting like I owe a shit, I heard the beat the same raps that gave the track pain.
I like the way that happened right there.
Yeah. Back pain, fucking up my money, so yeah, I had to act sane. Shot nigga, but he's holding my accent. Shit came up to me and said, this the number 2 dial. If you wanna make it number 1, you're number 2 now. Miss that goose in Malibu, I call it Malibu, yeah. Goddamn easy, I would hit him with a new style. Know that motherfucker well, what you gon' do now? Whatever I wanna do, gosh, it's cool now.
I need to see your fucking hands at the concert. I'ma need to see your fucking hands.
Sasquatch, Godzilla, King Kong, Loch Ness, Goblin, Ghoul. A zombie with no conscience. Question, what do these things all have in common? Everybody knows I'm a motherfucking monster. Conquer, stomp it, stop your silly nonsense. Nonsense, none of you niggas know.
Who's this here?
Jay-Z.
Oh, this is Jay-Z. Oh, shit.
That I've seen. I still hear things scream in my dreams. Murder in black convertibles. I kill a block, I murder the avenues. I rape and pillage your village, women and children. Everybody wanna know what my Achilles heel is. Love, I don't get enough of it.
Gossip,
wow, that was
stop it. Everybody
that
know
verse.
I'm a
that was a really. Does he write that verse, Jay-Z? Oh wow.
I'm a nigga hand.
pull up in a monster automobile gangster with a bad bitch that came from Sri Lanka. Yeah, I'm in a tanga, color of Willy Wonka. You could be the king, but watch the queen conquer. Okay, first things first, I'll eat your brain. Then I'ma start rocking gold teeth and fangs. Cause that's what a motherfucking monster do. He a dresser from Milan, that's the monster do. Monster Giuseppe Hill, that's the monster show. Young Money is the roster and a monster crew. And I'm all up, all up, all up in the bank with the funny face. And if I'm fake, I ain't noticed cause my money ain't.
Let me get this straight, wait, I'm the rookie. But my features and my shows, 10 times your pay. 50K for a verse, no album out. Yeah, my money's so tall that my Barbie's gotta claim it. Hotter than a Middle Eastern climate.
Well, this is really
it.
Good, eh? Fuck. Holy shit.
Jeez. She wrote that too?
Yeah.
Holy shit. Wow. She has a crazy, crazy way of phrasing delivering. And doing delivering. Yes. Yeah. She delivers and wow.
So that's a monster.
Wow. Wow. First time hearing Jay-Z and first time really honestly hearing
Nicki Minaj
go like that. And both Jay-Z and Nicki Minaj's features there are fucking fantastic.
Yeah.
She can deliver. And Jay-Z too. Like I've only heard Jay-Z on, I think I heard him with, I heard her, heard him and her, Alicia Keys.
Yeah, the Alicia Keys song, New York.
New York, New York, yeah.
Not New York State of Mind. That's the Nas song. Empire State of
Mind. Empire State of Mind, yeah. That's the only time I've heard Jay-Z, so that was wicked. He's got it. You know what's crazy is that everybody, you think that people, like, well, from outside or not knowing hip-hop, is that you think that everybody's sort of got their, they're pretty much the same, right? It's like a country singer, right?
Yeah, you but think it's
no,
so, no.
You think so? No, every, from... Like from Kanye to Minaj, they're really, really completely different.
Yeah.
Everybody's delivery, everybody's, is it called flow, I think?
Yeah, flow. Flow. Delivery and flow.
Yeah, the way it is, it's completely different and completely different than Kendrick.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
100%. Like, this is so different, but it's, that was a fun track.
So moving on to track number 7. It's called So Appalled. It's featuring Jay-Z again, Pusha T, Sci-Hi the Prince, Swizz Beatz, and RZA from Wu-Tang Clan.
RZA?
Yeah.
Not Rizzo.
Who's Rizzo?
That girl.
That's Lizzo.
Oh, Lizzo.
No. You got it totally wrong, man.
Okay, you can make sure you cut that part out.
I'll cut it out for you.
Yeah, right.
One hand in the air if you don't really care. Two hands in the air if you don't really care. It's like that sometimes, I mean ridiculous. It's like that sometimes, it's shit ridiculous. One hand in the air.
But if you don't mind, I'ma keep you on call. We are but a law, we don't give a fuck about y'all. I got dogs that'll chew a fucking hole through the wall. But since they all love us, I need more rubbers. And if I don't use rubbers, need more covers. Housekeeping, I mean goddamn one time. Let it be a bad bitch sweeping. That no we.
How should I begin this? I'm just so offended. How am I even mentioned by all these fucking beginners? I'm so appalled, I might buy them all. Just to show niggas how much more I have in store. I'm fresher than you all, so I don't have to pause. All of y'all can suck my balls through my drawers. Dark night feeling, die you be a hero. But live long enough to see yourself become a villain. I went from the favorite.
Those strings in the back really make it dark,
would
yeah.
Would you rather be underpaid or overrated? More victories is for minor league coaches.
Take it how it come, a half a million 20s like a billion where I'm from. An arrogant drug dealer, the legend I've become. CNN said I'll be dead by 21. Blackjack, I just pulled an ace as you looking at the king in his face. Everything I dream, motherfuckers, I'm watching it take shape. Watching you, I'm just a young rich nigga that lacks faith.
I am so outrageous. I wear my pride on my sleeve like a bracelet. If God had an iPod, I'd be on this playlist. My phrases amazing, the faces and places, the favorite. Huh. My cup overrun up with hunters, dummy. Damn, it's hard not for me to waste it. The new commandment, thou should not hate, kid. My movement is like the civil rights. I'm Ralph Davis. Ralph Davis. Abernathy.
Yo, champagne wishes and dirty white bitches. You know the shit is fucking ridiculous. Fucking ridiculous. You know the shit is fucking ridiculous. Cars for the missus and furs for the mistress. You know that shit is fucking ridiculous. Fucking ridiculous. You know the shit is fucking ridiculous. 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 Fucking ridiculous. Ridiculous.
It's like that sometimes, man. Ridiculous. Life can be sometimes ridiculous. Huh?
Yeah.
Well, that's a really good track, dark track. It sounds very dark because of those strings.
Yeah, I think the strings make it dark, and then the lyrics are kind of just, I don't know, I feel like this track is very, I don't know if it's storytelling, but it's just, you know, you've got a bunch of people. It's not too complex like the other tracks that we listen to in terms of different parts, but it's like people are coming in and going.
It's funny you just said
constantly.
That. That's what I was just going to say. Like the coming in and going is what makes it really cool because your ear hears this different voice.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's like every 30 seconds you've got a different person telling their story.
Yeah.
Cool
track. It's not like it wasn't the one that just knocked my ass off. Like,
yeah, yeah.
Like
all the lights or
all the lights and stuff. Yeah.
Next track is titled "Devil in a New Dress," and it's featuring Rick Ross.
I love it though. I love it though. You know. Put your hands to the constellations. The way you look should be a sin. You my sensation. I know I'm preaching to the congregation. We love Jesus, but you done learned a lot from Satan.
Boy, it's a crackling, eh?
Yeah.
I mean, the nigga sample. Did a lot of waiting. We ain't married, but tonight I need some consummation. I've said a word. I've said a word to me this evening. Can't get your tongue. Is
this a sample or is it played?
No, this is played.
Is it played, right?
Yeah.
The other part was a sample, right?
Yeah. Okay.
There's some guitar in there, I hear it.
On to the next sport. New Mercedes sedan. The Lex Sport. So many cars.
I love all
the
stuff
thought it was mail from.
Going on in the background. I'm
different traps I was getting mail from.
Grooving to that bass line. That string.
Whole click appetites had tapeworms. Spinning Teddy Pendergrass. Final as my Jay Burns. I shed a tear before the night's over. God bless the man I put the sights over. Getting Tupac money twice over. Still a real nigga, red coochie sweater, dice roller. I'm making love to the angel of death. Catch your feelings, never stumble, retracing my steps.
That was Pusha?
Rick Ross.
Oh, Rick Ross, okay.
That's Devil in a New Dress. What do you think of that?
It was okay. Like, it wasn't one. I was my mind was blown with the other ones.
Mm-hmm.
So this one was a little bit slower for me, but I really liked the loop at the. It must have been a sample at the beginning, right?
Yeah.
It was a big chunk of samples at the beginning. I really liked the. It was good. It wasn't my fucking boom. Wasn't that, you know, knock me off my ass type of one, right?
Yeah.
Lyrically, it was good. And I really liked that guy's voice when he came in. It was
Rick Ross.
I really like. I'd like to hear more of that guy.
What about the guitar solo in the middle?
I like the solo in the middle, and I was gonna say actually it's interesting because they keep using dirt,
mm-hmm.
a distortion. It's sort of more of not a like a real dirty dirt. It's more of a fuzz.
Mm-hmm.
It's like they're using a fuzz pedal, and they used it on the other track earlier.
Yeah,
and they use the fuzz pedal now. So I think it's some kind of like the theme is just to have that fuzz going in the. And it's in the right ear, too.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's a little fuzzy, you know. And it's an actual, it's called fuzz.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
Right? So it's not just distortion. It's like fuzz.
Yeah. Anyway, next track is titled Runaway, and it's featuring Pusha T.
That's an analog piano.
Mm-hmm.
Standard. Well. It tricked you, you know that?
Yeah.
It got me really, really calm with that single note. Oh, I like this.
Gotta never take work off. Baby, I got a plan. Run away fast as you can. individual pictures in my email. I sent this bitch a picture of my dick. I don't know what it is with females, but I'm not too good at that shit. So I think it's time for us to have a toast.
I like that pre-chorus.
Let's have a toast for the douchebags. Let's have a toast for the assholes. Have a toast for the scumbags. Every one of them that I know. Just have a toast for the jerkos. Gotta never take work off. Baby, I got a plan. Run away fast as you can. Run away from the baby. Run away. Run away from the baby. Run away. Run away as fast as you can. Run away from it, baby. Run away. Run away from
it,
baby.
Dirty
suit. Yeah.
Run away. None of them get crazy. 24/7, 365. Pussy stays on my mind. I did it. Alright, I admit it. Now pick your next move. You can leave or live with it. It could buy a train with that motherfucking top off. Split and go where? Back to wearing knockoffs. Ha, knock it off. You've been putting up with my shit just way too long.
This is a great pre-chorus.
Yeah.
Then it comes in with a. You know what? This part here is like an anthem.
Okay? Yeah. So
I can hear the whole 60,000 people.
Let's have a toast for the douchebags. Let's have a toast for the assholes.
Thank you. kind of dirty keyboard.
This is him singing.
Is it? Oh, wow.
Through some kind of... Wow.
Oh, cool. Because it had that...
It's him singing the chorus, but... You can hear the breaths.
Oh, yeah. Oh, there?
Wow, from the start of that piano, the single notes, to the ending of that, you wouldn't think that that piano starting the single note was kind of...
Bring all that.
Bring all that in. That pre-chorus, the verses are great, right? But mm-hmm. the pre-chorus and then going into that... I don't know if people do that, if they
at
go...
At concerts. Yeah.
At concerts, because if he does sing that song at a concert or, you know, 60,000 or 30,000 or whatever, I would have to be doing that.
Yeah.
And screaming it at the top of my lungs. It's yeah. such, it's calling out for, that's a stadium song.
100%, yeah.
Like, it's a full stadium song.
I think
song,
this right? album has a lot of stadium. So yeah. All the Lights is definitely a stadium.
Yeah.
Yeah, how do you think about the last 3-4 minutes of just the auto-tune singing the chorus?
Well, you know what, I was, as it was going on, and I was trying to decipher what it was until you told me that it was his voice, I was picturing a really, really wacky guitar. You know the, you know where the guys use the talk boxes?
Mm-hmm.
And I thought he was, somebody was doing with the talk box, right?
Yeah.
And then you told me that. But what makes one think in production, okay,
to do that?
Yeah, you finish off and you just, the epic chorus, and then it's blum.
Well, when it went back to the piano.
Yeah, yeah.
He probably could have ended the song.
That's
there.
What I figured he would. I figured it would start that way and it would end
that way.
But what, I don't know. See, that's creativity. That's something I wouldn't do. Did Kanye have a, or am I getting him mixed up? Did he have a sex tape?
No, his wife did.
Oh, his wife did.
Kim did, yeah.
Oh, okay. I just knew that someone had a sex tape. I've never had a sex tape. How do you get on, I know how you get on a sex tape, but like.
Well, nowadays it's easy. You just got to film.
No, but...
And we got the equipment right here.
Hey, tonight, there's too many mosquitoes out here. They just attack my ass.
Why would you do it out here, though?
Well, because the camera's out here.
No, I mean, you could bring it in.
Okay.
Like, you're not saying you do it with me, right?
No.
No, okay. I thought that's what you meant when you said the mosquitoes. I'm like, we're not doing it here, and we're not doing it. But if you want to use the camera, you can take it in later.
But how does it get out? That's what I'm saying.
The internet.
No, but somebody sneaks it out, or you do it for your own publicity?
You do. Well, you would do it for your own publicity.
I would, yeah, yeah, for
it's,
sure.
It's
yeah.
pretty, it's fairly simple.
You but nobody want to see my old wrinkled wiener.
We got 17,000 subs now. We'll let them.
There could be maybe out of those 17,000 people, maybe 2 would want to see an old wrinkled wiener.
Yeah, and it's me. It's one of them. Anyway, track number 10, Hell of a Life.
Oh, jeez. Oh, that's a really cool analog sound, man.
Yeah.
I think I just fell in love with a porn star. Turn the camera on, she a porn star. Turn the coroners in a foreign car. Call the coroners through the CPI. She gave that old nigga an osa. Bittersweet taste made his gold teeth fake. Make a knee shake, make a priest faint. Make a nun come, make a cremate. Move downtown, cop a sweet space. Grab my hand and baby, we'll live a hell of a life.
It was really cool.
So that was Iron Man.
Iron Man, yeah. Yeah.
Never in your wildest dreams.
Holy shit.
I think I fell in love with a porn star. And got married in the bathroom.
What a vocal thing, eh? Change?
Up, yeah.
Like it's really. Wow. Dance floor.
And got divorced by the end of the night.
That's a really trippy sound, man.
That's one hit.
Wow. another a feeling of real, like dark shit.
Yeah.
Like it's like just the way it is. It's just it sounds like, you know what I mean? It's just very dark. I don't know. It wasn't the Black Sabbath sound or anything. It was just just a real,
and not even the lyrics too much. It's just it's got that dark. I think it must be the instruments he chooses to use.
Yeah, and is he trying to portray that? Like, you know what I mean? There's a reason why you picked that dark feel, right?
Yeah.
Like you could have sang these he could have sang these lyrics to a totally different feel and it would have came out different, right?
Let's go track number 11, Blame Game.
Who's fault? Let's play the blame game. I love you more. Let's play the blame.
His voice is sure, you can, you know, distinguishable.
Yeah. Let's call John. Name.
It's soft.
Name. I hate you more.
On the bathroom wall, I wrote, I'd rather argue with you than to be with someone else. I took a piss and dismissed it like fuck it, and I went and found somebody else. Fuck arguing or harvesting the feelings, yo, I'd rather be by my fucking self. Till about 2 a.m. and I call back and I hang up and I start to blame myself. Somebody help.
Let's play the blame game. I love you.
See ya. Mogul get emotional every time I hear about other niggas stroking you. Man, say I hit you. They sitting there consoling you.
Rubbing my name through the mud.
Who's provoking you? You should be grateful a nigga like me ever noticed you.
Now you notice the bull and can't nobody get control of you.
1 a.m. and can't nobody get a hold of you. I'm calling your brother's phone like what was I supposed to do? Even though I knew.
Let's play the blame game. I love you more. Let's play the blame game for sure. Let's call our names.
Who's this?
Names.
Kanye. Oh, is he singing this? Oh, wow. No, I was like, wow, it's a different singer. I could tell by the tone, but I was surprised. I didn't know.
I can't love you this much. I can't love you this much. No, I can't love you this much. I can't love you this much. I can't love you this much.
And I know that you were somewhere.
Level. This is some Cirque du Soleil pussy now. Shit. You don't want all Pluto on a nigga, okay? And I love it. And I thank you. I thank you. My dick thanks you. How'd you learn? How did your pussy game come up?
Easy taught me.
I was fucking parts of your pussy I'd never fucked before.
Shit, this is long.
I was in there like, oh shit, I never been here before. I've never even seen this part of Pussy Town before.
He must have wrote this shit, right?
It's like
shit,
you got
right?
This shit reupholstered or some shit. What the fuck happened? Who the fuck got your pussy all reupholstered?
Yeezy reupholstered my pussy.
You know what? I got to thank Yeezy. And when I see that nigga, I'ma thank him. I'ma buy the album. I'ma download that motherfucker. I'ma shoot a bootlegger. That's how good I feel about this nigga. Oh.
Is there some... did something go on, obviously, with someone during this time?
Yeah, I mean, it's this. I don't know the backstory of, you know, Kanye's relationships, but I think it's the song is pretty self-explanatory in terms of
extremely. Yeah,
he was banging this girl, showing her the rich life that he's gotten. She ditched him to just bang some guy back home or whatever, and then he called her trying to get a hold of her, and she called back by accident. And then you got
Chris Rock on the other
That's right.
It is what it is. It's self-explanatory, and I really like the hook with John Legend, and I thought that Kanye really surprised me with his voice there. I was like, fucking John Legend, his voice changed a little bit. But he surprised me on that one, right? But it's pretty self-explanatory. It's one of those tracks, right?
Yeah, no.
It's got a good hook, but I definitely not play this on radio.
No, yeah, it's like 7 minutes long.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah.
It's not going to... Not because of the lyrics or anything.
Not because of the lyrics, yeah.
Track number 12 is titled Lost in the World. It's featuring Bon Iver with a bunch of features. Alicia Keys is back.
Alicia. Hi, Alicia. I'm looking at you.
On the additional vocal section. And then the ending track is titled Who Will Survive in America. So.
I'm up in the woods.
Oh, that's really cool.
I'm out on my mind. I'm building a still to slow down time. I'm up in the woods. I'm down on my land.
I like that effect.
Yeah, it's so good.
Yeah.
Down the town. I'm lost in the world.
Wow. Oh, I'm digging those toms.
Into a classic night. If we die in each other's arms, still get laid in the afterlife. If we die in each other's arms, still get laid, yeah.
I think Kanye's a horny dude.
Those drums from Tusk again. Radiohead used them.
Yeah, everybody loves them.
Everybody loves those toms.
What does Webster say about soul? All I want is a good home and a wife and a children and some food to feed them every night. After all is said and done, build a new route to China if they'll have you. Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America?
Is that from the? Is that clapping from the studio?
I don't know, actually.
Oh,
but that's the album.
That's good. It's really good. It's really, really good. And this track is a really good song to close this off.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with that statement, "Who will survive in America?" is the end of this album.
Yeah.
Right. Really, really.
It's very grand.
Very grand
finale.
Yeah. Exit. Man, this one really, some crazy, crazy vocal chops going on here. And strong.
Yeah, so now that we're done the album, do you understand the Suits a little more?
Yeah, I understand the Suits a little more, and I understand what I wanted to say too is the two albums I've listened to, sort of hip hop now, completely different. Did my question, I guess, for you would be, is that did this come out of it? Was this something that sparked something new?
This album here?
Yeah.
Yeah, this, not exactly this album, but the album before this.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I think in the Kendrick video was 808s and Heartbreak.
Oh, okay.
Which is kind of the album that Kanye fans and the hip hop world would say kind of sparked a change in everything.
Really?
Yeah. This album kind of Kanye took what he was doing on that album in terms of the auto tune and the more poppy singing stuff,
like on this one.
He took it to this album and kind of learned how to perfect it in a way, and experiment with it more. But yeah, this album definitely carries a lot of influence into what we hear nowadays in hip hop and
because it's so again what I heard before, right? Mm-hmm. It's just, it's so different. It's like everything on this album was different. There was one that was, his rhymes were, and then it was just I forget which track it was, but it was one of the, it was like, it wasn't, didn't have all the textures and everything going on. It was more little bit old school type of thing, mm-hmm. but everything else was just grand.
Yeah.
Like some, you know, from the Elton John, Alicia Keys one to this one with Bon Iver, and then the vocals, him starting out, it was like, everything was so production wise and just so grand and so epic, right? I came into this not knowing much about Kanye other than controversy, and I have a newfound respect, and I'll clearly say that out. I just didn't know what he did.
Musically.
I didn't know what he did musically, yeah. I just saw the bad, you know, the shit, the press, you know, the garbage, right?
Mm-hmm.
I got to figure out what the chicken tenders are, or chicken strips? Fish sticks. Fish sticks.
Yeah.
Well, I got to go to Saturday Night Live and see what
is. Saturday Night Live was another thing. That was South Park.
Oh, that was South Park.
Yeah.
So I've got South Park.
He's got a lot of controversy you can look up to. Yeah. Up afterwards.
You know, maybe I don't, you know what? I might not.
Yeah, I mean.
I don't need to, because you know what? This album changed my perception of who he was. And him being a producer, him bringing everybody in, I totally respect the suit thing because I know what he was trying to get at.
Mm-hmm.
And the pictures, the things that were on, you know,
the wall
in the studio and stuff like that I saw. So now I can go back after hearing this album and watch the rest of that, which you're gonna put in the link.
Yes, right? I'll link it in the description for you guys. Most Kanye fans probably know which one I'm talking about because I think the video had like 3 million views or something. So you've all probably seen it, but I'll link it anyway if you haven't. It's a great video. We'll do some more. We have one more hip hop album that we have to do because it's been on the poll and it was highly requested. That's Mad Villainy with Madlib and MF Doom, which are two names that you probably don't.
I know of a ring you have, and then the album on the wall.
That's about it, right?
Yeah. Who's that? That's Mad Villainy?
That's Mad Villainy. That's their group together.
Oh, okay.
Two of them. But anyway, thank you guys for watching, and we will see you next week. Stay safe. Much love. You got anything you want to say?
Yeah, just say stay safe and take care, and thank you again for the overwhelming amount of support and kind words. Words are nice when they're kind, so be kind.
That's a quote. You got to put that down, write that down somewhere.
What did I say? I forgot already.
I don't know, but we got to
see, your memory's better than mine.
Anyway, words are fucking...
Nice when they're kind.
Kind of nice, something like that. I don't know.
Words are kind of nice.
See ya.